Bioremediation is a process used to clean up water and soil with microbes, in which we use magnetics to enhance the process. The result is the, quote, best, unquote, system now available, faster, cheaper, and more efficient. After reviewing the different systems available in bioremediation, our system was selected as a superior method by the engineering company of the United Nations to be utilized to clean up toxic waste in their programs of foreign countries. The first to be initiated will be in Poland, and there's about 12 other countries online that will follow after that. We do have some sites here in the United States, but we expect the foreign markets to proceed much more rapidly. There is a lot of political and other reasons why things are not just moving very fast in cleaning up the environment in this country, which reminds me, and I am going to ad-lib a little bit, you'll have to pardon me. There was one criticism that I read about the talk Tom Levy and I gave last year. They said we didn't talk enough about the FDA. What in the world can I tell you all about the FDA you don't know about? My God. You know, I'm not going to sit up here and tell you about the FDA, all the times I talk with them, letters and meetings with them. And I'm not going to sit up here and tell you about all the times I've had meetings with naval research and all the hundreds of thousands of dollars I spent, you know, trying to get the government to take this stuff free. I'm not going to tell you about the NATO tank and the aluminum process. And some guy in the government said, you ruined my job. I wasted $2 billion up here if we accept this. I'm not going to tell you all about that. I'm not going to tell you about my meetings with the CIA. You know, they got a research director, you know. They read the Inquirer, too, you know. No, I'm not going to tell you about those things. Why should I? You guys know that you can't do much with those organizations unless it's something that they want to do something with, you know. But I must tell you a little interesting thing about meeting with the CIA. And I've never been in the CIA, by the way. I just did intelligence work for the government. They did ask me to be the deputy director, which is number two man, by the way. He runs the show, by the way. But and I was only asked, I wasn't asked by the president, I was asked by the gentleman that the president wanted to be the CIA man, and then he said, if I take it, I want you to be my deputy. And we both decided not to take it. Thank God we did. Anyway, but I must tell you what happens when you go to a CIA meeting. You got something to tell them. And it's very interesting. Whenever I wanted to have a meeting with the CIA in Washington, I'd have a meeting with the CIA. But if I ever wanted a meeting with some other top government organization or agency, it always wound up with the naval research. Now, some of you out there may have, that might mean some significance to you. Anyway, naval research had a lot of control on a lot of things in this country. So you go into a CIA meeting, you go into a safe house in Washington, you walk in, it doesn't look like a CIA place. Secretary there doing a little business, might be a real estate office, insurance business. You go in, you go to the elevator, you go up the second floor usually, you get off the elevator, Marine Guard, stop. And I don't care what kind of clearance, by the way, you've had 24 hours clearance with the FBI before you go there. They update your clearance. I don't care who you are. And so I don't care who you are, they frisk you, they look at your briefcase. And they take you down and they take you in a room, they sit you on one side of a big conference table, big table, not round, mind you, square. Round, you get to know people too well, you know. Square table. Okay, always square. All right. And you sit on one side, and these fellows, they come in the door on the other side, see. Now, the very interesting thing about these meetings, there's always chairs in back of you, see. But these fellows, they come in, they sit around the table, and always a couple of guys come and sit in back of you, you know. You've been checked out, you know, but you got a couple of guys in back of you all the time. Okay. Anyway, I thought you'd like to know at least. I'm sure that hasn't changed in Washington. That goes on a little bit.